So, Irina, tell me, what was the thing that surprised you the most about Irina?
So, I cannot say that I was surprised a lot of, but maybe the main moment of surprising was the visit in the library of Irina, because it's in the building of ex-church, and it's very big, it's very beautiful, and I think it's a very nice place to study, to read books, or maybe to participate in some events here.
Very interesting. Okay, how would you describe Irina to your family in one word?
I think if I should describe Irina to my friends, to my family, first of all, I should mention Extremadura, because it's not so popular region, I mean, in our world. Mostly people know Andalusia, maybe they know La Mancha because of Don Quixote novel. So first of all, I will tell about Extremadura, and after I will tell about Irina, and I will tell maybe that this is very interesting and cozy town.
Okay, very interesting. Okay, what are the activities that you have enjoyed so far in Irina?
We had a big variety of different activities.
Okay.
And I can say that from cultural point of view, I really enjoyed the cuisine, like Extremadura cuisine.
Yeah.
And gastronomy experience, what we had here. I also really enjoyed flamenco.
Yeah.
It was an amazing thing for me. And also I really enjoyed our sport activities, because I understood that I could do more than I thought before.
Okay. So what do you think are the strong points in Irina that differentiates the city from another city?
I think it's really a treasure for people from big cities.
Yeah.
Because here they can have all facilities what we are used to have. But at the same time, it's very small, it's very nice, and you can walk everywhere. You don't need any car or public transportation, and you, as a big city dweller, you can have a really nice rest here. And also, it's easy for you to go somewhere to the nature, because everything is pretty close. You don't have to spend much time to get in any place.
That's totally right. Okay, how would you improve this local city to make it even better?
I don't know. I also had in my mind like that probably the people who work in a touristic area, they need to improve their English. From other side, maybe it's like truly interesting experience when you are trying to explain yourself as a person who doesn't speak English.
Yeah.
So it's also kind of, let's say, linguistical adventure. So maybe now I don't have any particular piece of advice.
But you don't have advice like how the locals can improve their English? Maybe take some crash course in the language?
Yeah, maybe it might be nice, but anyway, for me, I might survive even if local people don't speak English.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.